brother. Oh, what's up?
This is a good recording, man.
Yeah,
I
brother,
can dig it.
Stop right off.
Hey, man, what's your name?
Good morning and welcome to the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 844-967-2789. That's 844-967-2789. You can text us at that same number. Good morning to you, Calvin. How you doing, man?
I'm doing pretty good. You know, the fog was insane on my drive in this morning.
Man, you weren't alone. You know, it was really kind of unbelievable just how thick it was.
Yeah, it was near whiteout in some places.
Yeah, but it's burning off already, you can see. And so there's a positive aspect to it, Calvin. The fog is only there if it's warm enough, right?
Yeah, well, I don't know if that's a positive or a negative.
Well, I mean, the warm weather is always a positive. But I got an awful lot to talk about this morning. Dr. Craig of Citizen Action won't be with us this morning, but you and I and Calvin will be able to hold down the fort without question. I'm really excited about a lot of the topics that we'll be talking about this morning. And before I go any further, I want to extend a heartfelt thanks to all of you who take the time out to listen to the show each morning. I know our audience is growing, and I'm really excited about that. I select topics, you know, very carefully, and I really do attempt to bring information to the listening audience that they may not get from a perspective anywhere else. And so we're going to, you know, stick with that this morning, as I'm going to have some discussions about things that are going to anger some people. But I'm not a puppet. I'm not controlled, and nobody gives me talking points. And I think that's part of what makes the show successful. Nobody tells me what I should be talking about. And I really would be honest with you. You know, at this stage in my life, if somebody wanted me to become a puppet and say, Earl, you know, you can stay on the radio if you, you know, talk about the things that we want you to talk about, I for sure wouldn't be here. When you get to be a septuagenarian, you know, you kind of relish being free to speak your mind. You know, you may not be able to do that in your younger years, but clearly when you've reached a certain point in your life, your beliefs are what they are, and they've been predicated on your life experiences. And so to have other people control what comes out of your mouth is not something that I'm interested in. But let me begin by Calvin. The Wisconsin voters rejected the ballot questions that the Republicans placed on the ballot again in confusing language about whether or not the governor, you know, has the power to determine how, you know, federal dollars are going to be spent, especially those that came through from COVID and other places. And it was defeated soundly. Only the second time since 1990 that these referendums that Republicans stick on the ballots that nobody can understand other than, and always written in legalese to confuse voters who really want what's in the best interest of themselves, the citizens of the state. And because Republicans write this in a manner that it's not understandable, not legible to the average citizen, they've been able to get away with this. Well, this time around, hopefully it's a harbinger of things to come. It was soundly defeated. And maybe Republicans will think long and hard again about continuing to try to confuse and mislead the people of the state of Wisconsin. It was, again, the state legislature that decided to put this bill, I mean, this referendum, these referendums on the ballot. And really, it was not even close. So, you know, maybe this is the beginning. I think I know that after 15 years of having to deal with the Republican legislature and some of the outcomes of some of the elections, that the stranglehold that these conservatives and Republicans have had on the people of the state of Wisconsin are finally coming to an end. So I'm really, really, hopefully, excited about what this is going to mean in the long run. Our phone lines are always open at 844-967-2789, 844-967-2789. Let me go here. And Calvin, Nikki Haley, of all people, Nikki Haley has said to Donald Trump to end his attacks on Kamala Harris and her race. And so Donald Trump continues to do what Donald Trump continues to do, ramping up his attacks because he really feels, and in some instances, these have been winning, you know, these have been winning ways for Donald Trump. He's got a segment of the population who believes in him, so he can say anything that certainly doesn't make any sense. And there are people who continue to support him. But Nikki Haley, of all people, who was considered to be a running mate for Donald Trump, had this to say on yesterday. An exasperated Nikki Haley. This is not Earl Ingram talking for all of those of you on the right. This is Nikki Haley. She urged former President Donald Trump and fellow Republicans to abandon their attacks against Kamala Harris and instead focus on her policy position, saying Americans are too smart to buy into things that don't matter. Let me repeat that. Again, this is not Earl Ingram talking. This is Nikki Haley talking. An exasperated Nikki Haley urged former President Donald Trump and fellow Republicans to abandon their attacks against Kamala Harris and instead focus on her policy positions, saying the Americans are too smart to buy into things that don't matter. But, and by the way, the vice president and presidential candidate, Kamala Harris, is going to be back in Milwaukee again on this Tuesday. And I'm telling you guys right now, you know, I know that I'm going to get an opportunity to interview Kamala Harris at some time in the near future. I'm telling you right now, I'm going to get that opportunity. I've said this before, and I said this about, you know, the importance of Milwaukee to the election for Democrats. The city of Milwaukee is as key as any city in the entire United States with the election now of Democrats and Kamala Harris to the presidency of the United States. I'm really blown away by the fact that the city of Milwaukee, that is marginalized many times by the state in which it's in, is as critically important as it is to the election of Kamala Harris. I don't know how many times I have to defend my city, But this does show just how critically important the city of Milwaukee is. And, you know, she's not going many places across this nation to hold a major rally. And that's what this is going to be in the FISA Forum, right where the Republicans had their major convention. That's where she's going to be. She's going to be there with Governor Walz in the city of Milwaukee during the Democratic convention, having a major rally. You know, Donald Trump's been whining and crying about the fact that she's been using artificial intelligence, Calvin, to enhance the size of her crowds.
Well, I mean, that's just ridiculous. It's been disproven.
I know, but what else does he have, right?
Well, yeah, I mean, he's put, last election, he put a strong emphasis that he should have won because his crowds were bigger, so now his logic could be turned against him. He is not happy.
You know, Nikki Haley, again, I want this campaign to win, but the campaign is not going to win talking about crowd sizes, she told Fox News. Bret Baier on Tuesday night is not going to win talking about what race Kamala Harris is. It's not going to win talking about whether she's dumb. These are the things that, you know, the Republican presidential candidate, Donald Trump, is talking about. And the fact that he can have those kinds of conversations and they gain and have some gravitas does say something about the people who think that those things seem to matter. And so that's a handful of people. You know, that's a handful of people. And that's not the majority of the people. And let him keep on going down that road. But I'll tell you something. As we move forward in this conversation this morning, even Fox News' Rupert Murdoch, of all people, is souring on Donald Trump, and he believes that Donald Trump is a drag on the Republican Party. Things are getting better. The sun is shining brighter. And so it's Wednesday. That means Wednesday's with you and Earl Ingram and Calvin on the Earl Ingram Show. 844-967-2789 is the number. Got a lot to talk about on the other side.
I remember my first love affair. Somehow or another, the whole darn thing went wrong. But my mama had some great advice, so I thought I'd put it in the words of this song. I can still hear her saying, Boy, I see you sitting out there all alone, crying your eyes out, 'cause the woman that you love is gone. Oh, that's gonna be a whole lot of trouble in your life. Oh, so listen to me, get up off your knees, 'cause only the strong survive. That's what she said, only the strong survive. Only the strong survive. Yeah, you gotta be strong. You better hold on.
All right, welcome back to the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 844-967-2789. You can text us at that same number. Yeah, only the strong survive. And right now, you know, Donald Trump is, and the Republican Party is facing a difficult time. And it's not just from what is happening with Kamala Harris and Governor Walz. It's what's happening with Donald Trump. And this is, before I go to the phone lines, this is in the alternate this morning, and this is from Rupert Murdoch. Of all people, you know, Rupert Murdoch is, you know, the brain thrust of Fox News and the owner of Fox News and the Wall Street Journal. And he's now saying that Donald Trump is bad for the brand. Rupert Murdoch appears to be souring on Trump. This is this morning's, you know, alternate. Even though far-right media mogul Rupert Murdoch played a significant role in former President Donald Trump's rise to power, he may now be maneuvering to ensure his defeat, in 2024. That's according to a recent analysis in New Republic by Paige Umek, who wrote Tuesday that Murdoch's publications all appear to be taking an unusually adversarial tone regarding the 45th president of the United States. Citing the Daily Beast, Umek wrote that both the Wall Street Journal and New York Post, both of which are part of Murdoch's empire, have run various unflattering articles, op-eds, and editorials. In one column, Wall Street Journal editor-at-large Gerald Barker opined that Trump was looking like a loser again. The Trump of the past few weeks has looked and sounded more or less exactly like the Trump of 9 years ago. This is the problem, Barker wrote. It is this Mr. Trump who lost the presidency in 2020. It is this Mr. Trump who lost the House in 2018 and the Senate in Georgia runoff election in 2021. Yesterday, Sandy and I were talking about, you know, the fact that this is the third time Donald Trump ran for office. And we were talking about the fact that, you know, there are clearly people after he won the first time around who vowed to never vote for him again. So, you know, there clearly was a lot of people excited, especially many of those on the right who believed after what they were seeing with the issues with Joe Biden. Well, Donald Trump doesn't appear to be so bad if we look at Joe Biden. That's no longer the case. I think Donald Trump's house is crumbling. We'll see how he handles it. Well, many of us know how he's going to handle it. 844-967-2789. Let's go to the phone lines and Tom from L.A. Good morning to you, Tom.
Good morning, Earl. First, I am a proud democracy warrior. I do not believe in 2020. Project 2025, if it was on the Democratic side or the Republican side, I don't believe in authoritarian dictators. You set the table with a lot of stuff today, so if I'm going off a topic of any kind, please forgive me. The thing I would say is that Democrats continue to gain some steam here. The one thing I would really, really warn them is exactly what Governor Tim Walz said, which is, I learned the art of compromise without compromising my values. Because soon what we're going to start hearing as the GOP really realizes that they're going to be losing is they're going to say, we just all need to compromise. We all just need to get along. We just all need to do all this. No, we need to stick to our values. And we need to stick to the FDR agenda of a progressive agenda, such as Medicare for all. We need to stick to our agenda in terms of making it so people can have childcare for all. So therefore, people can actually buy houses. I'm hoping that before Joe Biden leaves the White House, I'm hoping that he actually forgives all the student debt. So therefore, all these people can start buying houses and we can actually start having an economy that works for everybody. I'm very, very excited about the change that's happened. They thought years ago that if they could buffoon the people of Wisconsin with Scott Walker, which they did for a while there, that they could basically take over the country because of our horrible electoral college system that we do have in place. But I just want to say congratulations to the people of Wisconsin. Like I said yesterday, you can take the boy out of Wisconsin, but not Wisconsin out of the boy. And I'm proud to be a Wisconsinite of a family that all still live there.
Well, so let me say this to you, Tom, and thank you very much for the call. You know, later on in the show, you know, I'm going to discuss something that is probably, you know, going to be an issue with Democrats. And it's about the fact that some Democrats are saying that Kamala Harris needs to move more to the center. And I'm going to challenge that moving more to the center. moving more to the right. You know, Tom just talked about Democrats and principles. But it is, I think, something that is going to haunt the Democratic Party. And for those who are looking to push Kamala Harris and Governor Walz to the right. I just for the life of me, you know, we've had enough of the right and the right policies and politics for far too long. But this belief that they've got to move further to the right, where is that coming from? But we're going to talk about that later on in the show. Let me continue with this. OMEC documented how both Trump and Murdoch have shown increasing levels of apathy for one another since Fox News called Arizona for the president, for President Joe Biden in 2020. A decision Murdoch personally signed off on after the 93-year-old billionaire said Trump went too far in his lies about the 2020 election, which cost Murdoch and Fox News $787 million in 2023 settlement with Dominion Voting Systems. The ex-president fired back on his True Social platform, calling him a MAGA-hating globalist. So, you know, Donald Trump and the Republican Party are headed towards a collision course, and that's good. You know, because they created that Frankenstein monster and then lost control of him. And now it's a matter of whether or not the Republican Party can survive after Donald Trump and MAGA is gone. 844-967-2789 is the number. You're tuned into the Earl Ingram Show. To the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 844-967-2789. That's 844-967-2789. Text us at that same number. You know, if you just follow this man who's running for president of the United States once again, you know that he has no way of uniting this nation. That's not who he's ever been, and he certainly can't be something that he doesn't believe in. On yesterday, an official social media account listed under Donald Trump's 2024 campaign posted a racist meme implying that if Vice President Kamala Harris wins the presidency in November, nice suburban neighborhoods will be overrun with hordes of black people and immigrants. Now, you can see the photo of what they have posted. It's a split screen, and on the left side of the screen, it's a nice, serene neighborhood with the flag out on the porch. And to the right of that split-screen photo, it says, your neighborhood under Trump, under the left side with the flag and pristine neighborhood. And on the right side of the photo, your neighborhood under Kamala Harris, and it shows a bunch of blacks in, looking as if You know, this is a total attack, a total riot, a total assault on the neighborhoods of people who live in the suburbs. This is the person that people think is a good person. This is the kind of person that people are looking to support, knowing what's in his heart. I mean, how can, you know, I've been around a while. I've never seen this kind of blatant racism and bigotry portrayed for the entire nation to see for somebody who's running for president of the United States. You can find this anywhere. Become the Third World is the title of the picture. This is Donald Trump and the Republican Party, and this is what we can expect to see between now and the election. And if you think that's all right, if you think that's okay, so be it. But I don't think the majority of the American people can be fooled by that. We already knew who Donald Trump was in the beginning. Do you remember, it wasn't so long ago, where Donald Trump, after his debate with Joe Biden, said, "I'm going to be the uniter." You remember that, Calvin? "We're going to bring the people together. That's what I'm going to do." And he showed this calmness, and people said, "The new Donald Trump."
Yeah, that didn't even last the whole speech. No, that lasted, man, like 20 minutes.
No, man. It did not. You know, I just don't get this. I don't understand it. While, you know, I mean, I understand Donald Trump. He's been that's who he's been all the time. That's why the other day when I had, you know, a black guy who's supporting Donald Trump in the studio, and he was telling me about, you know, the great things that Donald Trump, you know, was doing for people of color. Well, you know, your neighborhood under Donald Trump, nice, serene flag. Your neighborhood under Kamala Harris, total dishevel. Just a bunch of people rioting. And yet, people don't challenge that. Side-by-side images caption, your neighborhood under Trump and your neighborhood under Kamala Harris, respectfully, show a tranquil residential street and a 2023 Getty photo of recent migrants to the U.S. sitting outside New York's Roosevelt Hotel in hopes of securing temporary housing. The Roosevelt now serves as an intake center for homeless migrants and has been described as the new Ellis Island. Most of the migrants in the photo are people of color. Now, he's not hiding anything, you know, and yet, even as Harris and the Democrats shift to the right on the border security and immigration issues, the Trump campaign has doubled down on racial animus and anti-immigrant sentiment. In a conversation with ex-owner Elon Musk on the platform Monday night, Trump repeatedly vilified immigrants, you know, bringing up cases of alleged murders by undocumented migrants. "These are rough people," Trump told Musk. "These are criminals that make our criminals look like nice people. And it's horrible what they're doing." No, President Trump, former President Trump, you know, what's horrible is you playing the race card. And you know, and supporting bigotry in this nation. There are people who'll agree with you on that. But the majority of the American people clearly won't agree with you on that. Nikki Haley was just saying earlier, I was reading an article from Nikki Haley who said you're not going to be able to move, you know, the bar, Donald Trump, with those types of things. But when you don't have a plan and all you have is that, is nationalism, then that's all you can do. And when you're not bright enough to look at a nation that is a melting pot from its inception, those of us who know what America is know that America is not white. America and Americans are peoples from all over the world. That's what separates and differentiates us from all the other nations on earth. And that was always the thing about our nation that people looked at and wanted their nations to be similar. And no, Donald Trump, you won't be able to change that reality. You'll long since be gone, and the truth of what the nation is supposed to be will continue long after you and your racist beliefs are gone. Let's go to CJ. Good morning to you, CJ. You say what?
Good morning, Earl. Thanks for taking my call. And yes, you had that young black man, I believe his name was Orlando Owens, from the Joseph Project, and your desperation, and you claim that Donald Trump is bringing racism alive.
Hey, CJ, I'll give you a chance. Bring him down. I'll give you a chance. But I just told you, you totally omitted the conversation that, you know, that I just had. The Trump campaign just tweeted something really racist in every major newspaper across the nation. This is in it right now. Okay? And so it's the Trump campaign, absolutely. And those who support him. Because he can put this garbage out, and people like you totally omit it. You won't even acknowledge it. So when you want to talk about somebody who's trying to change the subject, that's all you ever do. Go ahead.
Well, I tell you what, I changed the subject. You know, when are you going to discuss what your candidate is changing her opinion?
Hey, CJ, thank you very much for the call. You know, I'm not, you know, it is just, it's that kind of mentality that allows Donald Trump to continue to divide this nation as he is with this garbage. And yeah, there are people like CJ who, you know, amen. He's in the amen corner. Hey, put more of this out. There needs to be more of that. There needs to be more gay bashing. There needs to be more bashing of people of color. That's all he has. That's all they have. There is nothing else. And then guys like CJ, well, you know, people say, well, you need to let CJ come on more, and you need to let him. For what? He has nothing to add. He can't even address these real issues that are impacting and affecting this nation. There's got to be enough people out here who are willing to challenge injustice wherever it stands. This is injustice. You know, import the third world, become the third world. That's what Donald Trump is saying. And he has no shame. And he needs to be called out on it. And for those of you, you know, who think this, we continue to attack Donald Trump. He just did this yesterday. You know, what is he going to do today? How desperate, how much more desperate is he going to become in the next 80 some odd days? And when do people call and say, hey, oh, wait a minute, man. Do you know what you're sounding like? Do you understand that? Do you understand that there was a time in this nation when that was accepted? But we've gone beyond that, Donald Trump and CJ. Some of us have grown beyond that. And we don't, certainly don't need a president of the United States who hasn't grown beyond that. Let's go to Susan from Kenosha. Good morning to you, Susan. You say what?
Oh, good morning. I was just talking about that this morning. There's a group of people who have not gone or have not grown beyond the rhetoric of the 1950s. And I'm so just upset with people like CJ. I don't even really like to listen to him. I know we have to listen and be respectful of everybody's view. That's what I was always taught as a child. And now that I'm 74 years old, I get to the point that I get really mad that, don't you see what's going on here? In what's going on here is that the Republican Party wants to take us back to those days when we were completely controlled, when everything was controlled by, and I hate to say this, the white man, the rich white man. And we were told to do to what we wore, what we thought, what was on TV, so on and so forth. That's exactly what went on. But we've grown beyond that. We have educated ourselves. We have learned that people of different colors and different faiths can be shared. Their faith, their beliefs, and everything can be shared. We can have what we have now, and we have to keep on moving forward. And those people who want to live in that 1950s style, go ahead.
Yeah, they'll be left behind, Susan. Thank you very much for the call. 844-967-2789 is the number. Your thoughts on the Earl Ingram Show. All right, welcome back to the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 844-967-2789. That's 844-967-2789. Text us at that same number. You know, racism is a go-to approach for Trump, as evidenced by his quest over a decade ago to prove that then-President Barack Obama was not born in the U.S. Some of his advisors have told the media in recent weeks of their plans to return to the Willie Horton playbook, referring to an infamous ad from 1988 that supports supporters of Republican George Herbert Walker Bush produced for his presidential campaign against Democratic Michael Dukakis. Trump's current pollsters and advisor Tony Fabrizio had a hand in that advertisement. According to the New York Times, GOP donors and Trump's own advisors have been pleading with him to attack Harris's policies and stay on message instead of questioning whether she is actually black. So listen, you can say, Earl, why are you bringing this up? It's not Earl bringing this up. This is where we're headed. And it's going to get nasty and ugly. It's going to divide the nation even more. He's got to be called out for that. At least Rupert Murdoch and Nikki Haley and others who supported him are saying this is not the way. This is clearly not the way to revert to racism and bigotry. Hey, it's 2024. All right, already. You know, If that's all you have, then they need to be exposed for that. Let's go to Brendan from New Jersey. Good morning to you, Brendan. You say what?
Good morning, Earl. Yeah, I live in the Northeast. We knew the racism level and the level of racism within Donald Trump years ago, the Central Park Five, the Obama birtherism. This is all part of the playbook he's been running since day one of coming down that escalator. Good people on both sides, you know. And then we excuse people, you know, who come back and say, "Donald, stop saying that." Well, those same people are backing him up. And I said it to your guest, Mr. Owens, the other day when he tried to tell us that black men were leaning towards Donald Trump. Well, I don't see him at the rallies. All I see in the interviews at the rallies and the people at the rallies are angry white people that haven't gotten over the fact that Obama was president for 8 years and gained a real certain level of respect and got some stuff done that was really good for the people of this country, the middle class of this country. So, you know, people like CJ will come on with their talking points because they can't hold any one subject. And this is why the border bill didn't get signed. So he could use this as a massive rocket that he could fire every day and then try to convince everybody, the red meat eaters on his side of the ticket, that look what's happening to our country. When I go out and I go shopping, I go in a store and I see different people of different colors and ethnic backgrounds. I see people that are trying to live and survive in this country. That's all I see. Trump people, when they're out there and they see these people, as poisoning the blood of our country and buying into all this crap. And that's all it is. It's just all crap.
You know, Brendan, they don't know. And they talk about the flag and they talk about the Constitution. And the people like CJ and others like him, you know, don't even understand what the purpose of the founding of this nation, you know, it's an experiment, because the entire human family of this earth is in this nation, right? I mean, you can go around the rest of the world and you don't see the mixing of people from all over the world in this nation like you do here. There's no other place on earth like this nation. So people who want to try and get away from that, especially a guy like Donald Trump, you know, as you stated, everybody knows, those of us who've been around a while know who he is. And so now, what is he? He's a wounded animal. It's exactly what you said. This goes back to, again, Barack Obama and people who basically said, we're never going to have a person like Barack Obama ever again. And that's why Donald Trump was selected to become the president of the United States, as crude a man that there has ever been in the White House. And the fact that he got his 4 years, Brendan, and should have just moved on, he sat back and sulked for the last 4 years and said, when I get my chance again, this is what I'm going to do. Thankfully, because of the kind of man that he is, the chances, I think, of him succeeding are getting slimmer every day. Don't fool yourself. It's not going to be easy. Absolutely not. But there are young people who are revved up, who weren't revved up before, that the Republicans can't get. Those are numbers they didn't count on going towards the Democratic Party. Younger people who don't buy into all of that bigotry and hatred. And thank God for that. It's their world. And that's why people like Trump and others who want to go back to a time that the nation was not much to speak of as it related to people interacting with one another is over. 844-967-2789 is the number. You're tuned into the Earl Ingram Show. I wish that you were-